Within SQL Server Big Data clusters, there are multiple options to configure the services running inside of the cluster. Michaela is here to tell us all about it, today on Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm your host, Jeroen, and today we have Michaela with us to talk about SQL Server Big Data Clusters configuration. Hey, how are you?
I'm good. Thank you for having me here.
Welcome to the show. So SQL Server Big Data Clusters configuration. Tell me, how does that work?
So thank you for having me today. We're going to cover a few aspects of how you can deploy Big Data Cluster in an optimized way to accommodate your type of workloads.
Okay.
So in order to do that before deployment, you need to plan like how to scale your services, how to configure different networking and things like that. So we're going to cover a few of those things and how, especially on the experience side, like how exactly you're going to do that within the Big Data Cluster.
Mm-hmm.
So what exactly can you configure when you deploy a Big Data Cluster? You can opt in to have certain services that are mission critical for high availability. You can also have security enabled, like you can integrate external services that are deployed within the Big Data Cluster with Active Directory. You can configure the scale, like you can deploy multiple data pool instances, multiple storage pool instances, and so on. Definitely storage. Storage is important.
Sure.
You want to to scale in that that aspect as well. Networking, right? And you can configure the ports that you want to the external endpoints to be exposed through. Pod placement, that is important to pin different services depending on resources that are required to different node types to that, you know, to accommodate different type of hardware that you want to use, as well as resources that, you know, that are allocated for various components. And I'm going to show you how exactly you're going to do that.
Right. So basically with all of these configuration settings, I can take Big Data Clusters and roll my own, right?
Yep.
To make sure that it fits exactly to what I have in my environment, what I require.
So
you
want to accommodate your environment, you
right.
want like your infrastructure, you want to accommodate your type of workloads,
sure.
right? Like, and if you're running more Spark or more SQL type workloads, definitely
right.
those things are flexible and you can do that.
So hopefully you help me do that, right? I wouldn't know how to start, so.
Definitely, so there are tools,
okay.
right? That we put out there so you can do that. First of all, how you deploy Big Data Cluster using AZ Data, and that's also the tool that you're going to use to configure before deployment.
Okay.
And later, when we're going to enable post-deployment configurations, you're going to do the same thing. And Azure Data Studio, right? Like now, soon enough, we're going to have a deployment wizard that will guide you through the experience of deploying, and then you're going to be able to specify it through that wizard experience what are different tweaks that you can you want to have for various services.
Okay. Well, I'm a big old Microsoftie, so I like my wizards, right? Is it going to be next?
Yeah,
next,
it's like next, but definitely you need to pay attention to what you want to configure and customize for. Again, you don't want to deploy and then realize, oh, I didn't put the port that I want to or things like
okay,
that.
Okay, so no next finish, pay attention.
Yes.
Good. Noted.
So let's see how that will work, for example, with AZ Data. We're going to show you in another session like how you do that with a wizard. I know it's your favorite.
I would like to see that. Yes, absolutely.
But let's see how that is going. Because, you know, to be fair, the wizard is actually using AZ Data underneath the covers, right?
Of course.
So what we're going to do to help you, we already have some built-in templates that I showed you actually last time in the previous session about deployment that we put there for you to accommodate various platforms that you're deploying, like if you're deploying on-prem or on Azure using Azure Kubernetes Service. We have different configurations that are particular for that type of environment. So that's you're starting from one of those templates,
okay.
And then you pretty much create the clone, like you clone it,
mm-hmm.
And then you use that copy to customize, and then you know, you can customize either using, you know, something like VSO or mm-hmm. You again. Your favorite AZ data tool, like it can actually do patching, and you can issue statements to replace values within the configuration files, and then you just deploy, and you the input to the deployment command will be this custom configuration,
right.
That we created.
So I don't have to create the configuration from scratch. So if I wanted to, I could probably.
You could. I'm going to show them how they look like. And
okay.
You're going to see that, yeah, definitely it's possible.
But you wouldn't.
But you want to start from something,
okay.
Right? So
great.
We already put out there, like, for example, the one for AKS.
Mm-hmm.
You don't really have to modify anything in order to have a minimum configuration, like a
awesome.
Dev test kind of cluster that you want to ramp up with on Big Data clusters. So nothing there is needed to modify. Everything is set up. I'm going to show you a more complicated one,
okay.
Though.
So, and using AZ data, of course, compared to the wizard, would have the added benefit, I assume, to that I would be able to script this,
yes.
And automate all of this?
Again, everything that you have here are commands that you can use in a script to automate it, either for your deployment pipeline,
right.
Test CI/CD kind of configuration. So if you have multiple repeats or that of deployments, then definitely scripting is your
tool. Okay, so can you show us how it works?
Yes, let me show you the deployment configuration files and how they will look like when. Okay, so when you create that clone that I told you, right? When you start from the template that we built in within Big Data cluster,
mm-hmm.
And I use I already created the copy, and I use a template for a kubeadm cluster, like
okay.
A Kubernetes cluster. It's not AKS, because I want to point out a few differences that you need to pay attention when you deploy in a Kubernetes cluster. It creates two configuration files, one for the controller service, which
mm-hmm.
is a set of services that help you manage the cluster. So what you have here, the actual controller service, right? And in this file, you're going to specify what are the Docker settings, like where all the images that are required
sure.
for Big Data cluster, that where are they pulled from, storage settings. And I want to highlight few things around
okay.
storage. If you specify a storage setting in the controller, all the services in the Big Data cluster are going to inherit these settings unless you override it in the file that is corresponding to the Big Data cluster services. And I'm going to show you how to do that.
Okay.
Something to pay attention to, because whatever you put here
mm-hmm.
is going to be used by SQL Server Master Instance or
right.
HDFS
everything.
And everything. So you
okay.
want to make sure that you either overwrite, right,
sure.
or whatever values you put here, they are according, again, to the type of workloads that you want to run and the data size that you want to load into the Big Data.
So can I see this as kind of the master blueprint of
yes.
all the
Yes, so this is the brain of your
yeah.
of your
cool.
Big Data cluster, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's... and then some endpoints that, again, networking settings that are exposed for... the controller, so to actually connect to talk to the cluster, like
uh-huh.
to this management service, and then to the service proxy, which is a endpoint that is used for monitoring components.
Okay.
And I told you about security, right?
Yeah.
You can enable security integration with Active Directory. That's another thing that you would configure through the controller. So everything from DNS settings and so on, you will input here.
Mm-hmm.
Then once you're done with this one, you move to configure the actual services that are running as what we call Big Data Cluster, SQL
right.
Server Master, HDFS, Spark, and so on, right? So if you look at this file, how it's structured, it has all the resources that are deployed, and we call them resources, like they are Kubernetes resources,
okay.
right? And within these resources, you have services that are running. Like
mm-hmm.
To give you an example, in Master, for example, right? What
yep.
is Master is SQL Server Master Instance. And what is the service that is running there is SQL. So SQL Server, we know in Big Data Cluster, it's running in master, it's running in the compute pool and data pool and in storage pool. Mm-hmm. And with each one of them, you can configure things. So let me show you, for example, that we are here with the master, right? In this case, I opt in to enable high availability for my, and the way I do that, very, very easy. I just say, like, I just want three replicas and everything happens behind the scene magically.
This is
it's too easy.
This is almost too easy, right?
But that you need to pay attention to all these details. That's the only thing. Like, you just need to understand what are the services that are being deployed and what and I can and cannot configure there. Because I'm going to deploy with Active Directory integration, I have to specify the DNS names for various endpoints, the external endpoints. And again, I have availability groups configured for master. That means that I have readable secondary endpoints. Yep. So I have to do that to configure that as well.
Okay.
And again, my storage configuration, right?
Of course.
So I want to highlight this because I want more storage, for example, for my master instance than what I specified initially in the controller. So mm-hmm. I would have to override those settings. Another important thing for a Kubernetes cluster, we don't know the class name that you configured in your cluster. It's not like we have some default class name storage classes that, for example, Azure Kubernetes Service has. So that's something that you'll have to provide, and it's not built in the template that we provide for you. So it's required when you deploy.
Okay.
So that's about it. Like, similarly for to give you an example for the storage pool, what that's have, you can specify the scaling for various services. So that's mm-hmm. how you, by specifying the number of replicas, you can override storage and so on.
Yep.
So that's about it. You know, like, there are something that I did not include in here, but you can definitely find in our documentation, and I can point you to where that is in on our doc page, is something how to do pod placement, like all these services, to pin them to the type of hardware that you want to deploy various services on. So that's something that I saw that customers are asking about, and
right.
it's very important when they deploy in production to make sure that they leverage the hardware and the infrastructure that I have for various type of workloads, either on the Hadoop or SQL
sure.
Server side.
Okay. Wow, this was a lot of information.
It was
but I'm,
hopefully
I'm,
useful.
Yeah, no, I'm very happy to see all these configuration files. I had a lot of trouble with it myself. And I'm happy to see that we have templates that help me get started. And then I love, of course, the easiness of saying, oh, I want this amount of replicas. I mean, that is something that I'm really looking forward to using. So thanks a lot for sharing. Thanks a lot for being
here.
Thank
you. Thanks.
And thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, comment on the video, and I hope to see you next time. Thanks.